Michael, all right? I'm gonna sing a little song, and unaccustomed as I am to public speaking. And I'd like to dedicate this to my beautiful daughter. By the way, if you don't know me, I am the proud father of the bride. I'm also the proud father-in-law of the groom. So I'm going to make this song to Mika with all my love, and I think it goes like this.
You know your daughter means the world to me. You know how much I love her. Well, I'd like to ask permission to marry your daughter. Young man. I mean, in this day and age, he could have sent me a text message. He could have sent me a tweet. But he didn't. And I respect him. Let me think about it. So Stephen and I, we decided to keep this conversation
going
between ourselves. We never told anyone in the family. And time marched on. Days turned to weeks, weeks to months. Summer to autumn. Autumn to winter. Winter to spring. And then one night I wake up with this strange, incredibly beautiful, fantastically divine, illuminating, prophetically profound, mind-blowing dream. And then I was in my dream. I'm standing on stage, pretty much like this. Next to my best friend Al. He's always by my side. And off in the distance, I see a big cloud of smoke. It looks like a sandstorm or something. And what appears to be the Sahara Desert behind that storm. I see someone like Lawrence of Arabia walking across the sand dunes. And he's heading right to me. And as he got closer, I could see he had a mask on. It's one of them surgical masks. He was wearing green scrubs. And the scrubs had like a Boston Bruins logo on the front. Yeah, let's get the scope around his neck. Boston Red Sox cap. And he comes up to me and he says, I said, what? Well, I can't understand you with that mask on. Take that mask off. Tell me what's on your mind. So he throws down the stethoscope, takes off his mask, and I can see it's Dr. Milo. Stephen Paul II. I said, Stephen, what's on your mind? And he goes, Mr. Halperin, you remember what I asked you last summer? I said, I'm not sure what you're referring to. He said, you know, can I marry your daughter? I said, which daughter? You know, make it, you know. And I looked at this guy with the green scrubs and the Boston Bruin logo and the Boston Red Sox. Can I really trust this man with the most precious thing in my life? I thought, this being a dream and all, I'm going to give him a test. A final exam. And I said, Stephen, I know you can't sing. I've heard you try. It ain't pretty. But I'm going to tell you what. If you can get your side of the family to sing along with me, the verse of this song, you can have the hand of my daughter. And Stephen got up And he went over to the side of the family. Yeah. He stood right in between. Get it? Get you? Yeah. Julius? Yeah. Yeah, and he felt the vibe of 57 years of longevity. A beautiful marriage. I said, take a note, Stephen. All right, Julia. And I said, on the count of four, I want to hear wise men say only fool rush. You ready? Your side of the family. One, two, three. Wise men say, wise. Right away, he asked me, how can I marry your daughter, Mr. Allen? I said, that was good, but well, great. I want to hear more feeling, more soul. Maybe we can get my side of the family to sing along.
Yeah.